This is the Kitty Hawk Flyer, funded by tech billionaire and Google founder Larry Page. The Kitty Hawk is a contraption being touted in Silicon Valley as a flying car, despite the fact that it absolutely is not that. I mean, it doesn't have any wheels, it's not enclosed. To be honest, it looks more like something out of one of the Star Wars prequels.
Now this is pod racing.
But Kitty Hawk aren't the only boffins trying to send us into the skies. This is the Aeromobile 3.0, which people are also touting as a flying car. But to me, it just looks like a little plane. And that's fine, but it's no flying car.
Really, all I want from a flying car is the wheels to go like sideways when it goes up, like shook, and then for it to go. But obviously, like the wheels would be on their sides, not upright.
Hello, this little tucker from Liberty is said to be the world's first flying car on sale. So that's it's just a f***ing helicopter. There's no guarantee we're gonna get Back to the Future style flying cars anytime soon, but that doesn't mean cool shit isn't on the horizon. This week, Poindexters from all over the Nerd Kingdom will be flocking to Dallas in the US to attend Uber's Elevate Summit, a flying car summit which follows up from the 99-page flying car white paper the company released last October. In the paper, Uber shies away from saying they will develop any actual flying cars themselves, but they're more interested in converting their existing ride-sharing technology to the skies, allowing for quicker trips for customers. For example, travelling from San Francisco to San Jose in 15 minutes, a trip that would usually take an hour and 40.
And while this is all very exciting, some investors are worried that this is a sharp turn away from Uber's core business of mistreating their employees.
But it's not just flying cars. Companies are now experimenting with different types of airborne menaces. Look at this terrifying quad bike of the skies. I feel like if you're gonna dress like a goon in a Fast and Furious film and your hover bike is called the Scorpion 3, people are just gonna assume you're evil. Just listen to the music they've chosen to accompany their video. Or if you're into a more of a DIY vibe, why not just hook a parasail up to the back of a dune buggy for that real Mario Kart experience?
Those might all look like insane death traps, but the tech to commercially send your car flying is not far off.
In January, the plane manufacturer Airbus said they'd have a prototype ready by the end of the year. But the tech is one thing, and laws are another. Governments are notoriously slow to get with the times when it comes to new science, like drones.
So even if you did buy a flying car, it's unlikely you'll be George Jetsoning to the Sprocket Factory anytime soon. Plus, who needs a flying car when you've got your imagination? It's enough of that.